Okay, hello everyone. I hope all of you are fine. So today I'm going to talk about three things. I'm going to discuss how to change the background on a chimera. Secondly, I'm going to talk about how to display the bonds and atoms of your protein molecule using chimera, and then how to select the super secondary structures to give them different colors. These three tasks I will be discussing in today's video. So to first of all change your background color, you have to go to actions, then you select color, and then there is the option that says all options. Now here you can select any one of these, and then you pick one color, and then you close the message box, right? So for example, you want to change the color of atoms and bond display, you can select anyone from here. For now, as I told you earlier, I'm going to show you how to change the background color. I will select this, and then you can select any one of it. Well, mostly the white is used, and sometimes people prefer black, and I like dim gray. So I've just selected this color and I'm going to now close it. Okay, to maximize the window, right. Now, to show this atom and bond, this type of atom and bonds representation of your whole protein molecule, like here you can see the atom and bonds representation of the ligand molecule. I want the same representation for my protein molecule. I'm going to actions, and then there is this atoms and bonds. I want them to show. You can show only, right? You can select the area for the display. You can even hide the atoms and bonds that are already, you know, displayed or already shown. And then there is this option to select the backbone atoms and bonds and show them. Also, we can select the side chain bonds and atoms to show. Right now, I'm going to show the atoms and bonds of the whole protein molecule. See, this now appears to be the atoms and bond display of the protein molecule. Now, this color that is the red, blue, and yellow. Now, this is the color that is, you know, by default defined for the heteroatoms. We can change the bonds and atom color from the color of option. Okay, so now I'm going to select the secondary structures individually, and then I am going to change their color. Again, we have to go to select, and then the structure option, then there is the secondary structure option. I'm going to select all of these one by one. First, I selected the coil. Look, the green color is indicating that the coil part is selected. I'm going to change its color by yellow. Always remember to clear the selection, otherwise it may disturb your set of steps. Again, I'm going to select the secondary structure, but this time it has to be helix, and I'm going to give it a cyan color. Again, clear selection. Then the last one would be the beta strands, and I'm going to color it, I guess, magenta. So this is how the differently colored secondary structures would appear on your protein. Now see, the ligand is now somewhere mixed in between this. So I'm going to select the structure ligand, and I'm going to give it a different color. This time it has to be red. Okay, so see, this is how you can, you know, label, sort of, not label, but you can give different colors to the different components of your protein molecule, just to differentiate between the different structures. So So that's all for today. Next, I will be talking about different tasks and different things that we always need to perform on camera. So if you find this video helpful, please don't forget to like and subscribe.